Okay, so if we recall our previous lecture, then in previous lecture we have derived transmission ratio equations for longitudinal feed, transverse feed, and automatic thread cutting in lathe machine. Now, so those motions we need to change. We need to change feed rate as per the workpiece and cutting tool material combination. So that's why we need to go for feed boxes. So using feed box, we can change feed rate as per the requirement. Today, we will be discussing about different types of feed boxes. So I think this presentation mode is visible. Please, anybody just revert. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So first of all, if we look the classification of feed boxes, then mainly it is classified in four categories. The very first is feed boxes with sliding gears. So these are nothing but similar to the speed boxes. As we discussed earlier, design of speed boxes, right? So here we are also having sliding gear clusters. So using those sliding gear cluster, you can set required feed rate, right? But again, the condition is if you are using sliding gears type of feed box, then again your feed rate will be in geometric progression, right? So that is the only condition. Then the second type is feed box with change gears, then feed box with gear cone and sliding key, and the last type is tumbler gear attachment, right? So these are the different types. So first, that we have already designed means the sliding gear cluster type of feed box. As I told you, it is similar to these feed boxes, and feed rates they are given in geometric progression. So directly we are moving to feed box with change gears. So first of all, if we try to understand this arrangement, then here this is the driving shaft. You can say, suppose this is the spindle. If you are talking about lathe machine, then this shaft one is driving shaft, and this shaft two, that is driven shaft, right? In between these two, we are having change gear on shaft two. The shaft three is a driven shaft, and here we are having change gear. So change gear is nothing but cluster of two gears. Here you can see two circles. So these two circles are indicating feed circles of two gears, right? Now, what you can do, as name suggests, change gear. If you want to change gear cluster, because right now you can see here compound gear train arrangement means driving shaft rotation that is transferred from this gear to this gear, and now this large gear and this small gear on shaft two, they are nothing but one gear pair, right? So from this, now this smaller gear motion transmit to this large gear on driven shaft. So in this way we get speed transmission from shaft one to shaft three. Now, as name suggests, change gear means you can change this gear cluster as per the required feed, right? So this combination is suppose giving you some speed. Then suppose now if you want a more reduction in the feed rate, then the requirement is I need to increase diameter of this large gear. So what I need to do, I need to replace this change gear by large gears. But as you change, as you go for large gear, then this center of axis should be changed. So for that purpose, this swivel arm is given. This is called as a swivel arm. So here, this arm is hinged about shaft 3. So if you want to accommodate large gear in between these two, driving shaft gear and driven shaft gear, then what I need to do, I need to swivel this position, because here we are having slot. So in that slot, we can fix any gear cluster, right? So large size of gear, then I need to increase distance between these two. So this shaft 1 and shaft 3, these are the fixed shafts. So I cannot change distance between these two. But what I am doing, I am relocating a center of shaft 2 by swiveling this arm up and down, right? So this is how this gearbox work. But the condition is, every time if you do this task, then that is time consuming. Every time you need to loose this nut, you need to remove this chain gear. Now you install one new gear cluster, right? And you lock it and then you operate it. So it is time consuming process. That's why if you look the application, then this type of feed boxes, they are in automatic and semi-automatic machine, where rarely we need to change feed rates, right? And in some special purpose machine tools like gear hobbing, thread cutting machines, right? So where you need to go for very, very less or very few feed rate changes, right? So in that type of cases, we can use this. Okay, that application, so quadrant, so this is what explained here, that entire process is explained here, that quadrant can be swivel about axis 3, so this lever can be swivel about axis 3, and can be fixed at any position for any size of change gear to mesh with gear 1 and 3, right? So this is how this change gear type of feed box work. And drawbacks, lot of time consuming, and that is why the application of this chain gear is limited, right? Okay, so next is feed boxes with gear cone and sliding key type, right? So here you can see, this is your input shaft, this Roman number 1, that is your input shaft, and Roman number 2, that is your output shaft. On input shaft, we are having one group of gears which are fixed on shaft 1, right? So this all for example, here we are having 4 gears. So these 4 gears, they are meshed with opposite 4 gears on output shaft 2. But these gears on output shaft, they are loose fit on shaft. So what happened, if you rotate this input shaft, then this all 4 input gears, they are fixed on shaft 1, so they all 4 rotate. Now this 4 input gears, they mesh with 4 output gears, so those 4 output gears will also rotate, but this output gears, they are not fixed with shaft 1, right? They are fit on sleeve. So due to that, what happened, that rotation of these gears will not transmit to shaft 2, means this all output 4 gears, they will keep on rotating, but motion will not transmit to shaft 2, your output shaft, right? So to decide which gear should transmit motion, for that this sliding key is given. This key, which is indicated by number 1, numeric number 1, so this is sliding key, which is spring loaded. Here you can see one spring arm, right? So always this spring will try to push this key outward or in the upward direction, right? And now this key is fixed with shaft 2. And here you can see this number 2 is indicating one pulling arm. So by using this pulling arm, you can slide this key along the axis of shaft 2, this Roman shaft 2, right? You can slide it. So now you can clearly see here, if this key is fixed with output shaft 2 And if you insert this key in output gear 2, then motion will be transmitted from output gear, this output gear 2 to this Roman shaft 2, right? So this is how you can change now your feed rate. Now instead of this, suppose I want higher feed rate, then I need to slide this key in this first gear on the left side, right? And if I want very, very less feed rate, maximum possible, minimum possible feed rate, then I need to locate this key on the rightmost gear on the output shaft. So the diameter is large, so I get very, very less feed rate, right? So in this way, using this pulling arm, which is indicated by number 2, you can slide this key, and you can engage any gear with the output shaft, and you get your required speed on the output shaft. And this output shaft is again converted, connected further to the feed rod, right? To get the desired feed rate. Okay, now what are the advantages or the positive feature of this design? This design is very much complex compared to the previous design. And the control is simple, means by if you just consider the previous case, change gears, then every time you need to stop your drive, you need to disengage change gear, you need to arrange one new change gear, and then you need to operate your machine. So as in when you need to change feed rate, you need to change gears combination. So that is time consuming. So in comparison to that, in this case, in case of gear cone and sliding key type feed box, it is very fast. You can easily control speeds or the feed rates, and it is very rapid as well, right? So that is what the advantage of this drive, gear cone and sliding key type of feed box. But what are the drawbacks? As you can clearly see, due to the motion transmission, this shaft 2 is rotated due to this key is positively fit in the key slot which is given in the gears, right? So due to that, it may happen whenever a high amount of torque is transmitted, then this key may stuck in any gear, right? So that is the one issue, because the transmission of to change your feed rate, you need to relocate this key in any one gear. But if it's stuck, then you need to give more amount of sliding forces. So that is one issue, right? Then second is low rigidity of driven shaft due to long keyway. So if you look here, this shaft 2 is having a lengthwise keyway, right? So due to that, the rigidity of shaft 2 will be less due to this key slot, right? And inability to transmit large torques. The reason is here we are getting a positive motion due to engagement of this key with any one gear, and that is due to the friction actually, right? So if you go for some large torque, and if that torque creates a friction which is more than the friction between this gear and this key, then slip may take place, and due to that, this type of drive, they are not able to transmit large amount of torques. So these are the some of the drawbacks of feed boxes, right? Now next is the application. Then where do we find this type of feed box? Then they are used in small and medium size lathe and drilling machine, where you require less amount of feed rate. So if you look here, suppose if you want 10 different feed rates, then how many gear pairs are required? Need to go for 5 gear pairs, right? Because each pair is giving you some different feed rate, right? So if you want 5 different feed rates, then you need to go for 5 gear pairs, right? So in that sense, this is used for small and medium sized lathe machine, but the actual dimension is keep on increasing. Now here you need not to go for geometric progression, right? If you go for sliding gear type of feed box, then you need to go for feed rate in geometric progression. But here different combinations of gear, they are giving you different speed. So it is not necessary that feed rate is in geometric progression, right? Okay. So this is about gear cone and sliding key, right? Okay. And the next one is feed box with tumbler gear or Norton gear. So first of all, let us try to understand how that change in feed rate is possible, or let us discuss about working of this mechanism, this drive. So if you look here, this is your input shaft. Shaft one is your input shaft, and shaft three is your output shaft. In between this shaft one and shaft two, we are having, suppose this is front view and this is side view of the same, then here you can see one swivel arm is given. On this swivel arm, we are having two pulleys. This pulley is on shaft 3 because this arm is swiveling on shaft 3, right? So this gear, this small gear is on shaft 3, and this large gear is on free end of the swiveling arm. So this gear is actually ideal gear, which is connecting this input gear with the output gear, right? So this is ideal gear. So this is side view and this is front view, right? So here now you can see on input shaft, we are having number of gears arranged in cone configuration, and these gears, they are fixed. This cross mark is indicating this gear, this input gears, they are fixed on input shaft one, right? So if we rotate or if we connect this input shaft with the gearbox output shaft, because as we discussed in previous session, generally feed boxes are connected after speed boxes, right? Due to getting constant T by R ratio, right? So this is your input shaft of feed box, which is connected to output shaft of speed gearbox, right? So rotation of this input shaft cause rotation of this entire cone gear, where we are having number of gears with different diameters, right? So this all gears, they will rotate. Now we need to decide how much RPM we need to transfer on the output shaft 3. So for that, what you can do, you can shift this entire cluster with swivelling arm on this output shaft. So this output shaft 3 is actually a spline type of shaft, right? So you can slide it on this output shaft 3, right? So what happened is, suppose if you want a high feed rate, then input gear diameter should be large compared to output gear diameter. So we go for this extreme leftmost gear, right? So we slide this gear cluster, this entire swivelling arm on shaft 3, such that this gear, which is on shaft 2, that mesh with this first gear of shaft 1 on left side, right? But to do that, we need to change center distance, right? So to manage that center distance, you can swivel this arm about shaft 3. You can swivel this arm. So if I want to engage this gear 2 with this gear, then I need to swivel this arm outward, right? I need to swivel this arm outward. So swivel that arm outward, and then after, you can see here one locking nut is given. So you can lock the position of swivel arm, right? So after locking the position of swivel arm, now what happened? This gear on input shaft, which is given on left most position, that will rotate this gear on shaft 2, which is ideal gear, and this shaft 2 gear that will rotate this shaft 3 gear, right? And shaft 3 gear that will cause rotation on shaft 3. So this is how you can get different possible speeds on output shaft 3 from input shaft 1 by locating the position of the swivel arm at any position along the shaft 3, right? So what are the positive features of this feed box? So positive features are like, it's a compact design compared to a previous case, because if you look, in case of a cone pulley type, a cone and a key type of feed box, suppose if I want 5 different speed, then I need to go for 5 gear pairs, right? But here in this case, if I want 5 different speeds, then on this input cone I require 5 gears, and on this output swivel arm always we require 2 gears only, right? So within 7 number of gears you can achieve 5 speeds. So in that way, this design is compact, as well as number of gears are required less, and operation is also simple. This will not stuck with the so that stucking issue which was present in the previous case, that is not here, right? So these are the few benefits of a tumbler gear type of feed boxes. So this gear which is ideal gear, that is called as a tumbler gear. This ideal gear which is connecting input shaft gear with the output shaft gear, that is called as a tumbler gear. And this is also known as Norton drive, right? Then what are the applications? Generally, this type of gear boxes, this type of feed gear boxes, they are available in thread cutting lathes, where you need to go for more variations in speed, right? Limitation, insufficient rigidity and accuracy of meshing. That is the one issue with this arrangement. Because always whenever you go for spline arrangement, then rigidity of system is the question mark. So here also on the output shaft you are having spline. So due to that, the rigidity of this drive is less compared to two drives. One is feed box with sliding gears, and second is feed box with chain gears. So feed box with sliding gear, they can transmit maximum possible torque, and as we move from sliding gears type to this tumbler gear, then that torque transmission capability is keep on decreasing. Means the maximum possible torque transmission capability is available in sliding gear type of feed box. Less than that you get in chain gear. Less than that you get in key type of feed box, and very less in this tumbler gear, right? So these are the different types of feed boxes. Now let us try to correlate this with our transmission ratio available in lathe. This is what we discussed in the previous lecture, right? So let us try to correlate this all. So here motor is connected to speed gear box. Speed gear box output shaft is connected to a spindle of lathe, and that output shaft of gear box is also connected to input shaft of feed box. So this UD is indicating feed box, and from UD next we go for UG. So UG is again a chain gear. So I'll just show you after this one another slide where actual picture of this entire arrangement is given in lathe. So let us try to correlate this all the transmission ratios. So after UG, next we have UT. So UT is what? That decide whether you want power thread cutting or power feed, right? So for that we use half nut. So this is half nut. So to indicate this UD and UG, now let us go to actual image of lathe drive. So here you can see, this is the entire arrangement. So this here, this is your output shaft of gearbox, actually speed gearbox. So from output shaft of speed gearbox, this is the gear which is meshed with this gear. This gear is meshed with this another gear, and this gear is meshed with, you can see here, some number of pins available on backside of this disc. So there we have one another gear, right? So, and now this entire arrangement, which is indicated by this gears, that is what the tumbler gear is, or the Norton gears, right? So here you can see, this is your sway arm, and this is the guide to fix the location of sway arm. I hope this strip is visible. So on that strip you can fix this sway arm at any angular position, right? And this is what your input gear from output gear of a speed gearbox, from this to this motion transmit, and from this to this you get motion transmission, right? And then after, next, as this gear is engaged with this gear, so I call this gear, and this backside gear and this front gear, these two are on same shaft, so both will be rotating at same RPM. But now from this gear to this last gear, in between these two we are having one change gear. So this is what called as change gear, right? So this is indicated here. So this is called as a change gear. So, and this is the swivel arm of change gear. If I want some different feed rate, then right now you can see a large gear on change gear, and on backside here I think you can see one small gear. So this both are called as change gears, right? So suppose now if I want to change feed rate, and suppose that feed rate is not available from this change gear, then I need to change another set of change gears. So I'll just remove this change gears and I'll use another set of change gear. But due to diameter difference, I need to swivel this arm and then I need to fix it, right? So that you get a engagement between this input gear and this output gear through this change gears, right? And then this output gear is actually nothing but it is connected to your feed rod, your lathe feed rod. So this entire arrangement is of lathe machine. This entire arrangement is of lathe machine. So here your feed box is actually combination of Norton gear and change gear. Why we need to do that? Because we want more number of speed, more number of feed rates, because this lathe machine is a general purpose machine tool, right? So there also we require more number of variation in the feed rate. So that's why this combined feed box is used, right? So I hope this explanation is clear. This is the actual system, actual feed box which is used in lathe machine.